So now we have a vector. So for example, suppose, so now we have a vector alpha in Rn. So alpha is of the form, so let's, for example, let's take alpha equals to x1, x2 up to xn. What are we going to do? We're going to find a vector in the direction of the vector alpha. So suppose we have the in Euclidean space Rn, we have the vector alpha. What we're going to do? We're going to find a vector which is the same direction as the vector of alpha. So for example, so here we go, here we have a vector in the same direction of the vector alpha. So for example, this vector is gamma. So let me write that down. So we have a vector, so let me take the vector. Here we have the vector, we are talking about the vector for this vector alpha. So alpha is a given vector, and we're going to find a vector gamma. So gamma is our vector. So for example, let me take gamma. I'm just want to change my color to its whites. Okay, so gamma is a vector, so is a vector which is in same direction as the direction of the vector alpha, but the magnitude of the vector gamma is 1. So basically we want to find a vector in the direction of the vector alpha and which of length 1. So we're going to find an unit vector. So because gamma is a vector in the same direction of the vector alpha, so gamma must be some constant k into alpha. So k is for some real, so k is a real number k. So gamma is some k into alpha. So what is the k? K is also, look over there, k is also, we are taking k is positive. K is also positive. Why k is positive? K is greater than 0. Why? Because if I take k negative, then gamma must be in the opposite direction of the vector alpha. So gamma may be in the opposite, gamma will be in the opposite direction of the vector alpha. That's why what we take k greater than 0. And one more thing here, we are talking about all vectors alpha, given vector alpha which is non-zero vector. We are talking about non-zero vector alpha. So for a non-zero vector alpha, we want to find a unit vector which is in the same direction as the direction of the vector alpha, but magnitude is 1. So here we go. So gamma, magnitude of gamma is 1. So from there, what we get? So from now, norm of gamma or the length of gamma is 1. From there, what we get? So put that value. So we get gamma dot gamma, so standard Poisson product into gamma with gamma is given 1. Now put the value of gamma. So what we get? So gamma is k into alpha, so it will be k into alpha into k into alpha equals to 1. Now what we're going to do, we're going to find the, now k is a constant, alpha is a vector, so k alpha is a vector, and so k alpha dot k alpha, so it's a standard inner product. What we're going to do, we will going to calculate now the value of k alpha dot k alpha. So let's find let's calculate the value of k alpha. So what is k alpha? So here we go. So here k alpha, so let me write down the k into alpha. So what is k? K is a real number. What is alpha? Alpha is x1, x2 in this way. So it's going to be, so let me write them down. It will be x1 comma x2 in this way. This will be xn. Now what about the k alpha into k alpha? So k alpha into k alpha gives, so now k into x1, this is the component wise multiplication, so it is gives us kx1 comma kx2 comma kxn dot kx1 kx2 and in this way kxn. Because the standard inner product is a component wise multiplication, so this component must be multiplied with this component, so this gives us k square x1 square plus k square x2 square. In this way, this gives us k square xn square. So value of this dot product k alpha dot k alpha is k square. Let me take the k square outside the summation. So x1 square plus x2 square, in this way xn square. Okay, so what we get from that? So let me just erase this part and let me write then it out fresh way. So now from what we have, so let me write that down. So we have the vector gamma, which is going to be unit vector, which is a constant k into alpha. And what we have found out from there, we find out from this equation the length of gamma equals to 1. From there we get root over of k alpha dot k alpha is equals to 1, and we now put the value of k alpha dot k alpha. So this gives us square root of k square x1 square plus x2 square, and this way xn square, and which is equals to 1, because we take k is greater than 0, otherwise the vector will be in the opposite direction of the vector alpha. So k is a 0, so if I k square will be outside, will get k, and here we get basically x1 square plus x2 square plus xn square. It's a simple one. Now let's check what is the norm of alpha. So what is the norm of alpha? Let me recall that what's the norm of the value of alpha. So here let me erase this part. What is the norm of alpha? It's not a difficult one. What is the norm of alpha? Norm of alpha is basically the square root of alpha inner product with alpha. So what is alpha inner product alpha? So it's a component wise multiplication. So this gives us, so if we just multiply alpha with alpha, it's a component wise multiplication standard. So x1 square plus x2 square, in this way we'll get xn square, total square root. So now you can see from here that this from the here we get basically k into norm of alpha, because norm of this value is norm of alpha. So what is the value of k? So k equals to 1 by norm of alpha. So this is obviously defined because what we take alpha not as zero vector. So norm of alpha is a not non-zero. This is the non-zero quantity. So k is well defined. So what is gamma now? So then the value, the unit vector. So let me write down the what we get from there. So from all the thing over here, what we get basically, so here we go. So let me write them down. So any unit vector in the direction, so unit, so here let me write down unit vector in the direction, in the direction of a non-zero vector, of a non-zero vector alpha is the vector alpha by norm of alpha by the length of alpha. So this is our vector. So this is the unit vector in the direction of the vector alpha. So what we have to do if we so let me give talk about by taking an example what we have to do over here. So let's take an example. So first of all let me erase this and take an example from there. Yeah, I am taking your time. I'm sorry for that, but I have to take it. So here we go. Okay, so here we have, so suppose exercise or example. So find an unit vector. So example is find a unit vector in the direction of the vector in the direction of the vector alpha. So alpha is suppose 1 minus 1 0 2. So this is a vector in R4. So what we have to find? We have to find a unit vector in the direction of the vector alpha. The simple answer is, the solution is, this is a very simple, the unit vector, you can see that direction of the vector alpha is alpha by divided by length of alpha. Divided means just scalar division. So here you can write, basically you can write in this way. So alpha, this is the actually the correct way to write here. 1 by norm or 1 by length of alpha is the scalar quantity and alpha is our vector quantity. So solution is, what is the, first of all let me find the length of alpha, which is square root of 1 square. So square root of 1 square plus minus 1 square plus 0 square plus 2 square. So this gives us 1 plus 1 1 plus 1 plus 4, so it's root 6. So now the unit vector in the direction, so unit vector in the direction of alpha, in the direction of alpha is the vector 1 by norm of alpha. So 1 by norm of alpha into alpha. So what is the norm? 1 by norm of alpha, so 1 by root 6. Now put the value of alpha, which is basically, so what is alpha? 1 minus 1 0 2. You can lift it over here, you can leave it over here, or just you can write in this way. So 1 by root 6, just take multiply with each component, 1 by root 6 0 2 by root 6. So this is the unit vector in the direction of the vector alpha. So in this way you have to find a unit vector. Okay, let's talk about the next concept. Next concept is, when two vectors are perpendicular to each other or orthogonal to each other. So first of all let me write that down. So first of all let me erase this part and talk about that. I think you understand how to find a unit vector. Okay, let's talk about the next concept. Okay, I'm taking some time for that, but I have to go through this process, or just I can select all this and erase this. Oh, that gives us white page. Okay, I think it's okay to all of you. So here we go, we can change the color. So what we're going to do, orthogonal vectors to each other. So orthogonal vectors, so what is this means? We have to find, so suppose we have a vector. So for example, in some Euclidean space Rn we have a vector alpha. So in some Rn we have the vector alpha. What we're going to do, we have to find the vector beta, which is perpendicular to the vector alpha, perpendicular to the vector. So we have to find the vector beta so that the angle between them is 90 degree. So here is the basically definition. You can use these definitions. So we can use the standard inner product to define the basically when these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So here we go. So it says that here is the definition. Let alpha belongs to Rn, then a vector, vector beta in Rn is said to be, orthogonal or perpendicular, orthogonal, or just write, let me write the perpendicular to the vector to beta, to the vector r beta is perpendicular to the vector alpha, if their inner product, the standard inner product between them is equals to the zero, the real number zero, because we know that the inner product of two vector is equals to zero. So if I multiply alpha with beta, this gives us the zero over there. So a few more things over here. In this case, we write, so in notation, so in this case we write, we use this notation, we write alpha perpendicular to beta. So alpha, the vectors, alpha is perpendicular to beta. In this way we write basically. So one more thing from here, if the vector beta is orthogonal to the vector alpha, so that means alpha dot beta equals to zero. So from there, if beta is orthogonal to alpha, then what we have, then, or if and only if alpha dot beta equals to zero. So again, now what we know from their inner product, we know that if I multiply, so inner product is commutative, alpha dot beta gives us beta dot alpha. So alpha dot, instead of alpha dot beta, from there, so beta alpha dot beta is same with beta dot alpha. So from there, what we can write, therefore beta dot alpha is alpha dot beta equals to zero. So from there, what we can write, if beta is orthogonal to the vector alpha, then alpha is orthogonal to the vector beta also, then alpha is orthogonal to beta, orthogonal to the vector beta. That's the very easy observation, that if one vector is perpendicular to other vector, the other vector is also perpendicular to that vector. So in this case, they are the basically the same thing. So in this way, we just write, you that we just say the two vectors are perpendicular or orthogonal to each other. We will use that word, that alpha and beta are orthogonal to each other. So that is the one more thing. Okay, let's talk about the set of orthogonal vector. What is called, so first of all, let me give you an example of two vectors which are orthogonal to each other. So let me give you an example. So first of all, let me erase this part. Okay, let me erase this part. Okay, I can just erase the whole part from there. Yeah, that's a good one. So let me just example of orthogonal vectors. Example. So I am taking a vector in R3. So for example, alpha is our 1, 0, minus 1. So this is one of our vector. So this is a vector in R3. And this vector is, this is orthogonal to the vector, to the vector, this is a very simple observation, to a vector. Suppose this vector, I'm just write that alpha 1 basically, so which is basically minus 1 0 1 no minus just 1 0 1 let me take 1 0 1 instead of alpha, just 1 0 1 what we 1 0 1. So what we get if I multiply alpha with alpha 1, you can see that alpha with alpha 1 is, let me write alpha 1 0 minus 1 dot 1 0 1. We know that this is a component wise multiplication, so 1 dot 1 is 1 0, into 0 is 0, so minus 1 is minus 1, so we get 0. So this is a real number 0. So you can see that alpha and alpha 1 are orthogonal to the each other. So for this same alpha, we have another vector, so we can take another alpha 2 is basically, let me take, it's a half 0 minus half. So what we have from here, so instead of alpha 1, we now multiply alpha into alpha 2. What we get, alpha is 1 0 minus 1 dot minus half 0 minus half. Sorry, no, instead of minus half, just take plus half. So over here, so what we get from here, we get half, half into 1 is half, 0 into 0 is 0, minus 1 into half is minus half. You can see that again we get 0. So this vector alpha 2 is also perpendicular or orthogonal to the vector alpha. So you can see that one vector may be orthogonal to two different vectors. So this is not unique, that one vector have to be perpendicular to or orthogonal to exactly one vector. There may be infinite number of vectors to which one vector is perpendicular. So a vector, so let me write down a vector may be orthogonal to more than one vector. So it can be orthogonal to more than one vectors. So okay, let me talk about the what is called the orthogonal sets. So here we going to talk about the orthogonal set of vectors. So here we go. After that we just stop over here. We just talk about the orthogonal set of vectors, and in my next video I will give an example of orthogonal set of vectors. In this I just only state the definitions of the set of orthogonal vectors. So a set of vectors, in Rn, n may be any positive number, set of vectors Rn. So for example, say the set S is alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha k. So we have k number of vectors. So a set of vectors in Rn, say S, is called a set of orthogonal vectors, is called a set of orthogonal vectors, or as orthogonal set of vectors, a set of orthogonal vectors, or an orthogonal set if we have the following condition: if alpha I dot alpha j is equals to 0, if I not equals to j. So which means, it says that if we choose any two pair of vectors from the set S, these two vectors are orthogonal to each other. So each pair of vectors are pairwise orthogonal or orthogonal to each other. So each vectors are orthogonal to each other. So on the set, each vector are orthogonal to each other. And you can see that why I write that I not equals to j, because if I equals to I, so one vector is not orthogonal to itself. So a vector is not orthogonal to itself, so alpha i cannot be equal multiply with alpha I gives 0, except that alpha is a zero vector. So a non-zero vector, this is not true for a non-zero vectors. So that's why we take that I not equals to j. So in this set there may be a zero vectors, that's also allowed over here. But remember that what we choose over here, so instead we just any two non-zero vectors, any two pair of non-zero vectors for their multiplications, means the inner product, standard inner product is obviously equals to zero. On that case, the set of vectors is called, that set is called the set of orthogonal vectors. So okay, so here I stop the video. I think you will come back in my next video. In my next video I will give you an example of orthogonal vectors, the set of orthogonal vectors, and we'll talk about the set of orthonormal sets and so on, and the respective concept. So thank you for watching.